Welcome to another exciting edition of MacBreak Studio. I'm here at the Prescott location of MacBreak Studio, and we're going to look at some tips that Mark is going to share with us on warp speed editing, which kind of is a preview of a tutorial we're working on.
That's true. We have a new tutorial coming out on really how to become a Final Cut Pro 10 power user. So lots of tips about workflows and keyboard shortcuts and just things that we do to work efficiently and quickly.
Right, and that's look for that in September.
Yes. So this tip is specific to clip skimming and a really useful way to use clip skimming. Now, we've talked about clip skimming before in the context of multicam editing or Photoshop documents. Just to show you an example, I'll go to this. I have this Photoshop document with multiple layers.
Yes.
And you can't, you know, right now we can't see the thumbnails are turned off to make room. We can't see the thumbnails. If I enable clip skimming, which is Option Command S, and move the pointer over those individual layers, we can see their contents.
I think that's a great feature of Final Cut.
And all their contents.
The pointer just shows you what it is.
Yep. So that's one way to use it, but I want to show you something a little different. So I turn clip skimming back off. By the way, it's under the view menu, clip skimming. Not to be confused with skimming, the S
which
key.
Which skims everything which, under the
So here's the skimmer. Yeah, the skimmer moves, you know, wherever you go, it skims through the project. But if I skim over this shot of Charles here, I don't see him because it's being obscured.
By the secondary.
By the top. Yeah. So the skimmer just shows you the total composite. But clip skimming, Command Option S to enable it, will show me Charles or the clip depending on where I am. And you can see the icon changes now. That little bar is specific. It's inside the clip. If I turn clip skimming off, now the bar covers the entire timeline.
Yep.
Okay, so here's the scenario. I want to trim Charles. I've got, he speaks. I can see the end of his waveform there. I want to trim that first little piece that he's saying off. And I want to use keyboard shortcuts because I want to be a fast and efficient. I don't want to drag. So if I hit Option left bracket right now, what just happened?
Yeah, what happened?
So let's do it again. Let's see if we can see what happened. So watch what happened. Option left bracket.
It trimmed the wrong clip, it looked like.
Yeah, it trimmed the connected clip.
Oh, because the little white ball is
the little white ball
secondary
storyline. Yeah, that's active. So by default, if nothing is selected, the trimming operation will affect that top clip.
The active clip indicator.
Right. So you could drag and you do some other things, but this is where clip skimming really comes in handy. In fact, I'm just going to turn off regular skimming so it's not on there. I'll enable clip skimming with Option Command S. And now I don't really care where the playhead is. I'll move the playhead over there. I'll clip skim to right where I can see the dip in the waveform, and then I'll press Option left bracket. And that way I'm able to clip Charles directly.
That's very handy to be able to essentially target your pointer for your trimming operation.
Yep, exactly. So just by moving the pointer and seeing the clip skimmer, finding where you want, whatever your clip you're on, that is the clip that will be affected. So here's another example. I'll turn it off again. Let's say I wanted inside of this connected storyline to add another clip to the end. And let's say that clip is, this clip right here. I've got a clip here of some grapes. I know I've got some other clips of grapes, but I want to take that. So you might normally think, I'll take that and I'll drag it in here. And, that's replacing. I don't want to do that. I got to drag right to the edge. There, I did it. But that's kind of a pain in the neck.
Yeah.
Right? Think, we have keyboard shortcuts, right? E. So you hit E.
Yeah.
But E appends it to the end of the primary storyline.
It's always
a primary I'll undo
story.
That. I don't want to do that. But here's what's really cool. When clip skimming is enabled, Command Option S, no matter where my pointer is inside of this connected storyline, if I hit E, the clip gets added to the end of the storyline.
Now that is cool. I didn't know that. That's cool.
Isn't that nice?
Yes.
Isn't that nice?
That's huge.
And then it goes further, because if I have snapping enabled with the N key, that this little clip skimmer will snap to edit point, so I can snap to an edit point and hit W, and I can do an insert edit.
Nice, because the clip skimmer is now functioning as the kind of the absolute endpoint.
Right, and that doesn't work if you don't have clip skimming enabled. It will insert in the primary storyline. So this enables you to very quickly edit inside connected storylines using keyboard shortcuts.
I think that's great, because the other day I was frustrated, like why is it always forcing all the things to happen in the primary storyline using the skimmer? Or where the little white ball is. But now you can override that with the clip skimmer.
Clip skimmer, yep. So if I moved between these two clips and hit Option W, I can insert a gap. So all these great operations are available now with clip skimming. I'll undo that. If I want to overwrite a clip, I could select a different clip that I wanted to bring in. Say this clip of Charles here tasting a grape. and I wanted to overwrite from right at this point, and I don't care where the playhead is, I can move it somewhere else, I can hit D and do an overwrite edit there. Or I can hit Shift D and do a backtime overwrite edit. Oh, I didn't have the clip skimmer in the right place. Shift D and do a backtimed
overwrite edit. That's huge.
So it lets you do all that. It even lets you tap I and O to set a range, which you cannot do. Just to make it clear, I'll turn off clip skimming and move over here and hit I and O, and it sets it on the primary storyline.
Right.
You know, based on where the playhead is.
Yes.
So Command Option S.
So that clip skimmer has become tons
really
more useful.
Yeah. Really. I and O or click and whoops. Let me undo that. So I can clip skim and drag out. Oops. So let's stick with I and O.
Yeah,
I can drag it. I'll just stick it out. I and O. So I and O, and then I can delete that section. Command Z, or let's say I want to replace the gap, Shift Delete. I've got a gap. So it basically lets you do all of these operation within connected storylines.
That's a pretty good, power user tip. It's fantastic. All right, well, you just saw it. That's just a small taste of what you can expect when Mark's new tutorial comes out in September. Mark, thanks for showing us that.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
Thanks for watching us every week on MacBreak, following us on Twitter, and generally giving us all kinds of awesome support emails. We really, really appreciate it. We'll see you next week on the next episode of MacBreak Studio.